This is the next video on waves. This is what we're going to cover in this video. I want to start this video by having you observe a pattern that's going to be very important to understanding the rest of this video. I'm going to allow this wave to move for one full period of its motion, and I'm going to observe how much displacement it covers in that one period of time. So one full period will be the amount of time it takes this particle to move all the way up to the top of the wave, and then all the way back down to the very bottom. So let's see how far the wave moves in that one period of time. Okay, this may be kind of intuitive, but in one full period of motion, the wave moved exactly one wavelength of length. And there's no way that couldn't have happened. Like, when you stop and think about it for a little while, a wave has to move exactly one wavelength in one period of time. So this will always be true for any wave that we deal with. Any existent wave at all, in one full period of repetition, a wave moves exactly one wavelength of displacement. So that means that we can come up with a new equation for the velocity of a wave. We know that velocity is displacement over time, and because the displacement the wave covered is its wavelength and the time it took is the period, we can say that the velocity of any wave is its wavelength divided by its period. And because period is equal to 1 over frequency, I can rearrange this equation and say that the velocity of a wave is always exactly equal to its wavelength times its frequency. This is going to be a really important equation for problem solving in this unit. I'm going to give you some more visual intuition about how this equation works. So again, the velocity is the specific amount that this wave will move in 1 second. The wavelength is the length of one complete pattern of a wave. And the frequency is the number of wavelengths that will pass in 1 second, because frequency means repetitions per second. So the number of full repetitions of waves that pass in 1 second is the frequency. So to visualize this, I can see that here I have a wavelength of 3 meters. I'm going to imagine that we have a frequency of 1 hertz, 1 event per second. So this equation is telling me that if I have this wavelength and this frequency, it's going to result in a velocity of 3 meters per second. So let's now use this visual to see if that's... I'm going to have a frequency of 1, so that means that 1 wavelength will pass by in 1 second, and we'll see how much displacement it covered. So 1 wavelength passed by, so I can see that that frequency was 1 hertz. And the wavelength was 3 meters, so that automatically implies that the velocity it was traveling was 3 meters per second. It traveled exactly 3 meters from where it started in that 1 second of travel. We can imagine now that the frequency is 2, that 2 wavelengths will pass by, and each wavelength is 3 meters long, so that means that the velocity is going to be 6 meters per second. And if I allow this to happen, I allow 2 wavelengths to pass in 1 second, because that's the frequency. I can see that, yeah, altogether that velocity was 6 meters. It traveled 6 meters in 1 second, so the velocity is 6 meters per second. I can change the wavelength and imagine this is now a wavelength of 1. And if I give that a frequency of 1, so that 1 wavelength passes by in 1 second, I can see that the velocity was 1 meter per second and only traveled 1 meter in that 1 second. Finally, we can imagine a frequency of 4, so 4 of these wavelengths are going to pass in 1 second. And when I do that, I can see that the velocity is again the frequency times the wavelength. So again, that's 4 meters per second here. We can make 2 types of graphs of a wave, a displacement distance graph and a displacement time graph. A displacement distance graph shows the displacement of the material that the wave is moving through for each distance along the material. It's basically a 2D picture of the full wave. So as you can see here, I have a wave with a height from the very top to the bottom of 1.5 meters and a length of 4 meters. So if I were to make a displacement distance graph, the graph on the right would be what it would look like. I have sections of the wave clearly marked off leading up to 4 meters. I can see that the amplitude is going to be 0.75 meters because that's how far the highest point is from the midpoint of the wave, not from the very bottom. So this graph shows you the displacement of the material for any distance along the material that you're looking at. We can use the displacement distance graph to find the amplitude of the wave and the wavelength of the wave. So the amplitude I can see is 0.75. That's how far it is from the zero point. And I can see that the wavelength is 2 meters because one full repetition of that wave covers 2 meters. So we can use the displacement distance graph to find amplitude and wavelength. We can also make a displacement time graph of the wave. This is a little more complicated. A displacement time graph shows the displacement of one particle in the material that the wave is moving through on the y-axis and the time that has passed on the x-axis. So I'm going to show you an example of making a displacement time graph for this wave. I'm going to only focus on this one point because the displacement time graph only focuses on the displacement of one particle in the material that the wave is moving through. So I'm going to kind of ignore the rest of the wave and just focus on this one particle and what it's doing as the wave moves through it. I've sectioned off 8 seconds on this graph, so I'm going to allow the clock to run for 8 seconds and observe how the particle oscillates as the wave moves through it. And for every moment in time, I'm going to graph the vertical displacement of the particle on the graph. So I'm going to make a red line that shows exactly how high up the particle is for any 1 second of time. So just observe what happens when the wave begins to move through the material. Okay, so that itself produced a wave pattern. But remember, this is not a physical depiction of the full wave. This is a depiction of what one particle in the wave is doing for every moment in time. We can use the displacement time graph to find the period and frequency of the wave as well as the amplitude. So I can see here that the period is 8 seconds. That's the amount of time it took to complete one full wave pattern. So one full wave pattern on the displacement distance graph represents the wavelength, and one full wave pattern on the displacement time graph represents the period of the wave. And because frequency is 1/period, we can always get the frequency as well. Here the frequency is 0.125 hertz, just 1/8 seconds. And obviously the amplitude is still 0.75 meters, that didn't change. We can combine info from both graphs to solve for the velocity of a wave. So because we can use the displacement distance graph to get the wavelength of the wave, and we can use the displacement time graph to get the period of the wave, we can combine these two pieces of information along with the fact that frequency is 1/period to find the velocity, because to find the velocity, you just need the wavelength and the frequency. So if you have a displacement distance graph and a displacement time graph, you can get the wavelength from the displacement distance graph, the time from the displacement time graph, and put them together to solve for the velocity. So here the velocity would be wavelength times frequency, which is 2 meters times 0.125 hertz, which is equal to 0.25 meters per second. So that is definitely the velocity of the wave, and I can get that from the properties of these two graphs without observing the wave itself. We can also create graphs of motion given the other graph and the velocity. I can imagine here that the velocity of this wave is 0.33 meters per second, and figure out what the displacement time graph would look like. Because if the velocity is 0.33 meters per second, and I can see that the wavelength of the wave is 2 meters from the displacement distance graph, and the amplitude is 0.75 meters, plugging this into my velocity equation and rearranging to get the frequency gets me a frequency of 0.165 hertz. And the period is 1/frequency, and when I divide that out, I get 6 seconds. So that means that this wave has a period of 6 seconds and an amplitude of 0.75 meters. So if I draw that out on my graph, this is what that looks like, an amplitude of 0.75 meters and one complete wave pattern in 6 seconds. So that's what you need to understand to use displacement distance graphs, displacement time graphs, and calculate the velocity of a wave.